Hello everyone, thank you for joining us today for our webinar, Calculated Fields and Rollup Fields in Dynamics 365 CRM Solutions. My name is Katie and I'll be the facilitator today. This is a pre-recorded webinar, so if you have any questions, please enter them into the chat area on the left-hand side of your screen and we will have a response for you within 24 hours after this webinar ends. This session will be posted on our blog as well as shared with you later this week. Now, I would like to introduce our presenter today, Andrea, who is a solution specialist in Dynamics 365 Customer Engagement. Andrea, I'll pass it on to you.
Perfect. Thank you, Katie. Hello, everybody. So today we'll be looking through the calculated fields and roll-up fields, now called columns, so calculated columns and roll-up columns, if you do hear that used interchangeably. Looking at the agenda today, it's just nice and simple. We're going to create a calculated column and then create a roll-up column, and I will be showing how to actually create that, add that to the form, and some use cases that we can use it for. The first thing I want to note is, what is the difference between the two? So a calculated column is a field that has a defined formula. So based off of other fields or calculations for a specific table, we're able to add our formula and set that what that calculation is going to be. A roll-up column, on the other hand, doesn't do the calculation, but it provides you an aggregate value based off of related records. So that's the key difference here. The calculated column is based off of columns that are on the actual table itself, but the roll-up can be for related tables. All right, so let's actually go into our environment and look at how we can create this. So what you're seeing here is the actual contact record itself. So this is where I'm going to be creating my roll-up column and my calculated column. I will first start with a calculated column. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create a calculated column for a field such as the age. So on this contact, we're able to see the birth date field for this contact. But if we wanted to have the actual age number appear for this contact, which could be used for reporting, various analytic reasons, we can actually create this field. And what will happen is that based off of the birth date that is set, it'll automatically calculate what that age is. So let's look at how we can create this. I'm going to just jump to my Power Apps solution. So keep in mind, this does require privileges to actually create it. So if you are not able to do this, just ensure that you do have the proper access permissions, as well as I'm in a demo solution. So wherever you do house all of your tables, that is very important, just making sure that there is a methodology in place so you don't have any dependency issues when doing a deployment. So looking at the contact here, I'm just going to go right to my columns. And this is where it's going to be the actual fields. So again, we can see that I have this birth date field, as we saw on the form, that's where I actually would enter the date of the birth date. But let's now create that calculated column. So clicking new column right at the top here. I'll enter my name or the display name, make that an age. I can enter a description here. I can even indicate that this is a calculated column. It's not required, but if you did want to have that for future purposes, you're able to do so. Then we select our data type. For the purposes of age, I am going to just do a whole number because I do just want to know what is the age. Down here, format, again, I don't need any format, just based off of what I'm using this for. And then this is where I set the behavior. So as you can see that I have calculated and roll up. So how I set up both of these fields, field types is very similar. So I will select calculated. And I'll go save and edit. Now, something that happens that's very common based off of your browser settings is that once this saves, the pop-up might not appear just due to your browser pop-up permissions. That is completely fine. If it doesn't appear, you can actually click right into the field itself and edit it, which I'll show in just a moment. But just making note of, if you do save and you don't see a pop-up appear, it likely is due to your browser. All right, so I did have it appear right away. As you can see on my actual solution itself, I do have the age right here. If I did want to edit that age, I would just click on age and I would just have a button to edit it. So I can show that right now. page, and then here I'm able to edit that field. So if it doesn't pop up, or if you do have a calculation that you need to update, you are able to update it. You're not set with what you have there. So let's just give this a moment for this to load. There we are. All right, so this is where we actually set the conditions for a calculated field. The first thing that we can set is a condition. So this can be, it's optional, but it can allow some filtering for when do we want this calculated field to run. So for example, for a specific case, I can say if, and this will be my current entity, which is the contact. If I want the birth date, so let me just go down, to contain data, then it will run. So the calculation won't run unless that has data. Again, it's optional, so you can either save it. I won't have one just for this demonstration here, but that's just how you would set it as optional. And then the action is where we actually set what do we want this calculation to be. So here I will actually set the age value. So to find the formula that you need for this, and I'll make this a little bit larger, to find the formula that you actually need for this, there are different ways. We do have an article on our website right now that does have some different formulas and ways to use them as specific field types needed for them. But for us, we're going to use the diff in years. So what we're looking at here is we're finding the difference in years between right now and that individual's birth date. So we have the diff in years, and then we'll start adding what that field is. So we have the EBS birthday. So I'm setting that birthday. And I want to find now. So as soon as I start typing it, I'm able to see now. So what we have right now is find me the difference between today's date and the birthday. I just hit the check mark, and now I can save it or save and close. I'll just go save and close. All right, so now we've set what this calculation for this age field is going to be. Now let's add this column to the form. So I'll go to forms. This is my column, or my form, sorry. And I'm going to add age right just above the birth date. So let's go down here, find my H. Just drag and drop that in here, and save and publish. So now I'm adding this calculated column right to the form. What you'll notice here is that there is a lock right next to it. So a calculated column cannot be updated. So just making a note that you aren't able to override what is in the calculated column, as it is based off of a formula that we have set. So we'll just save this. All right. Now I'll jump to this next tab. This is our contact form, so we might have to refresh a couple of times just to see that new column added. There we are. So now we have the birth date, and we have the age defined right there. Again, if there is another contact and it had the birth date, it would just automatically change. And then each year as the contact gets older and older, this will update as well. So it's not set at a specific time. Also, if you were to change the birth date for whatever reason, maybe it's incorrect, it would update. So that is how we create a calculated column. So again, it's finding what the value is based off of the formula we've defined for another field. Now let's take a look at roll-up columns. So again, although similar for setup and how we set the conditions for it, roll-up columns again take the aggregate. So for this specific contact, if I go to the sales tab, I can see that this contact has two opportunities associated with him. And we see that there is an estimated revenue. So a roll-up column example could be, let's create a roll-up column that will take what this estimated revenue is, and it'll actually roll those values up, and we'll have that one. Again, if we need it for reporting purposes, any leads, sales, we can actually look at the contact and know what is the estimated revenue for the specific contact. So let's go about creating this. jumping back to Power Apps, just going to exit off the form and just go back. And I am navigating back to where we were with columns. So just like we had the age, I'll create a new column. I'll call this one estimated revenue. Now the data type here, because it is revenue, I will select currency. And for the behavior, we want it to be a rollup. Save and edit. The same thing goes for this one, is if you save it and a pop-up doesn't appear, it's likely just blocked by your browser settings. So just making note of that, that same thing where you can click right back into the column itself and you're able to change it. All right, so here we have this. Let's make this a little bit larger. So the first thing that we have is our source entity. So that's contact. Because we've built this on the contact table, we are not able to change this, which means that this field is going to be on the contact. Then we have use hierarchy, yes, no. So by choosing yes, you would include any parent-child relationships in the table. So for example, if there was parent-child relationships with an account and you wanted to find the value for all child accounts under the parent as well, you are able to define that right here. So here I can look at what is the related entity. So the related entity that I want to use is opportunities, because we're trying to find the estimated revenue for opportunities. So I'll scroll right down to opportunities, and it's for the potential customer. I'll hit the check mark. Here I'm also able to add filters. Again, I can do something similar as we saw with calculated columns, where maybe if an opportunity exists, so don't worry about rolling anything up if I don't have an opportunity. It is optional, so it's not required. And again, just like we had with calculated columns, you are able to make updates to this. So if you decide that maybe I do need a filter after all, you can always go back in here and add the filter. And then now we actually add the aggregation. So as you can see here, there is some predefined. So there's sum, max, min, average. I'm going to use the sum. And here I'm going to grab estimated revenue. So what we have defined now is that for a contact, find me all of the related opportunities and give me the sum of their estimated revenue, and it'll be in one specific field. So now I'll go save and close. Now, something to note as well is that for rollup columns, they don't always run in real time. They are set to be about 12 hours every single time that this does roll up. You are able to manually roll it up, which I'll show you in just one moment, but you also can define it in your system settings if you did want it to process a little sooner than that. So back to our forms, because I want to add this column now to the form. So just like we did for a calculated column, I'm now able to add this. I'll go to my sales tab. I'm going to add this column right above my opportunities just so we can see it. And then let's get our estimated revenue. All right. Now, unlike a roll or unlike a calculated column where there's a lock next to it, this one does have this little calculator and it does have this last updated on. So the last updated on is used just to show the last time that this was rolled up. But again, when we look at this on the form itself, I'll actually be able to show you how we can roll it up manually. Now we do a refresh again. All right, so here we have our estimated revenue. By actually clicking on this calculator field, I'm able to see this recalculate button appear. I can click recalculate, and here we're able to see that $95,000 appeared. Looking down here, I have $50,045, so it's rolled it up. Again, we don't have to do this manually every time. We are able to just wait and it will roll it up, but because there is that 12-hour Rollup time. If we wanted to see it in real time, that is a way that we can go about doing that. So that is how we create a Rollup column and a calculated column and the differences between the two and use cases that we can use for both. I'll pass it right back to you, Katie.
Great, thank you, Andrea, for the information. Thank you everyone for joining us today. If you submitted a question, we will follow up with you through email. Have a good rest of your day.